Hey guys, I'm JustJess from the Wine Channel TV network, and today I'm in Disneyland, aka Orlando, Florida. I decided to hit up the boardwalk at this place. It's called the Flying Fish. Look how cool this is. I'm right by all the chefs. They're cooking away, and I got my vino set up. First off, I have to tell you, on the menu, each selection actually has a wine pairing with it. So I decided to do actually the Riesling flight. And look at this cool little card. So I actually got two German Rieslings and one Washington Riesling. This whole flight was only $14, so you can't beat that. But let's get a little taste going on. So I'm starting off with my Rheinhausen German Riesling at first. And this was a spot lease. It's an 07. You get the nice citrus notes. Come on in. What do you got here?
We're the fresh baked sourdough bread made with rye flour.
Cool. Put it on in. Enjoy. I will enjoy. Thank you. I'm going to enjoy my wine first. But yeah, I got my Rheinhausen. It says even on here, slightly off dry. You definitely get the nice lychee kind of notes and honey flavors of the wine. It's very delicious. Next up, I got another German Riesling. Actually, this is the Mosel German Riesling. And again, this is a little bit, you definitely get the nice green apple. Again, citrusy notes right off the nose. You can tell because of the cool climate of where the wine's from. Let's give it a taste. Wow, talk about really sweet. Again, this is a Cabernet Riesling, so you definitely understand why you get the good sweetness. This would be great with a nice spicy dish, something with a little bit of kick to balance off the heat. And then the last Riesling we have here is our Washington Bernard Griffin 08. And again, you do get the really nice tropical, almost like pineapple kind of notes right off the nose. Let's give it a taste. Very dry. I don't know if you guys saw one of my later posts that I just did kind of recently. Rieslings now, within the next year, they're going to be labeling bottles saying if it's off dry, if it's sweet, just so people that don't understand a German terminology such as Cabernet or Spätlese will know, am I getting a dry Riesling like this Washington one, and so they know how to better match their food. So I think that all these Rieslings pretty much go great with this appetizer I decided to get, a nice shrimp cocktail, and also my fish for my main meal. Until next time, I'm JustJess reminding you that wine is just a conversation waiting to happen. Cheers! Thank you.